Here's something that'll get you out of your chair. Sitting for more than 6 hours a day doubles your risk of premature death. Not increases it by 50%, doubles it. And here's the kicker, even if you exercise regularly, prolonged sitting is still killing you. I'm Dr. Fergal Armstrong, and today we're talking about what researchers call the sitting disease. Let me break down what's actually happening inside your body when you sit for extended periods. First, the metabolism connection. When you sit, your skeletal muscle lipoprotein lipase activity drops by over 75% after just 18 hours. That's the enzyme responsible for breaking down fats in your bloodstream. Think of it as like turning off your body's fat-burning furnace. And here's what's remarkable. It only takes 4 hours of light walking to restore that activity to baseline. Second, the mortality data is sobering. In a major meta-analysis, people watching television for 6 or more hours a day had nearly double the all-cause mortality risk compared to those watching less than 2 hours. Television specifically seems worse than other sedentary behaviors, probably because it's completely passive and often accompanied by mindless eating. The mean daily sedentary time is 8.3 hours among Koreans and 7.7 hours among American adults. That's more than we sleep. Now, here's what this means for you practically. If you're someone who sits most of the day, whether at a desk job, driving, or watching screens, you're not just inactive. You are actively harming multiple systems. Sedentary behavior independently increases your risks for cardiovascular disease mortality, type 2 diabetes, certain cancers including colon and endometrial, hypertension, and dyslipidemia. But here's the silver lining, and it's significant. 60 to 75 minutes of moderate intensity physical activity daily can offset the mortality risk of sitting 8 or more hours. That's a brisk walk, cycling, swimming, anything that gets your heart rate up moderately. And if you can't do that much, even replacing 30 minutes of sitting with light physical activity reduces mortality risk by 14%. Standing desks, walking meetings, taking the stairs, these aren't just trendy workplace wellness gimmicks. They are legitimate health interventions. Here's something I tell patients that bridges my work in addiction and lifestyle medicine. Just like recovery requires disrupting established patterns, breaking up sedentary time requires conscious, repeated interventions throughout your day. Studies show that even when total sedentary time is equal, people who take frequent breaks have better metabolic markers, lower waist circumference, triglycerides, and blood pressure. The bottom line? Treat sitting like smoking, something to consciously limit. Set a timer for every hour, stand up, move for 5 minutes. Your lipoprotein lipase will thank you, and you might just add years to your life. Take care of yourselves out there.